creating these.
There are internal auditors everywhere, then how did that Vijay Mallya fraud even happen?
Okay, let's take two more problems so that the concept of cost of equity is crystal clear. So now if you look at this problem, okay, question number 4. So if you look at this problem, what are they saying? Government company expects to pay out dividends next year of 50 cents and its current share price is $5.2 and it expects its annual dividends to grow at the rate of 2%. Calculate the cost of equity. So, how does it go? Calculation of cost of equity. We are going to use the dividend valuation model. This is very important, guys. So, what is the formula for dividend valuation model? It is D0 into 1 plus G divided by P0 plus G. Correct? This is how I am going to calculate my cost of equity using dividend valuation model. So now tell me the figures that I will have to incorporate in my question, because they are saying that the dividends is how much? 50 cents. So 50 cents means how much? We all know $1 is equal to 100 cents. You don't know 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. Similarly, $1 is equal to 100 cents. So 50 cents is equal to how much? 50 divided by 100? It is $0.5. Now, this is a fact. This is common sense to know that $1 is equal to 100 cents. Alright, there is no concept behind it. Okay. Now coming to this aspect over here. So what is my dividend? My dividend is $0.5. But look at this question carefully. They're saying that government expects to pay out a dividend next year. So this next year is an important aspect in the question, which means that they are talking about not D0. D0 means current dividend. They have already given to us in the question next year dividend. A lot of students end up doing this mistake. You know what they'll do? They'll take 0.5, then again add 1 plus the growth rate and do the math and get the wrong answer. No, you're not supposed to do it that way, because what's given in the question is already next year's dividend. So this, the formula, we can cut it short to this. Alright. So how much is it going to be? Your D1 is 50 cents, which is nothing but $0.5. Divided by what is your market price of the share? Its current share price is $5.2. So this is my X dividend market share price. Why do I say that this is my X dividend market price of the share? It's because they are saying it is going to pay out dividend next year of 50 cents. That means current dividend is already paid. So if the dividend is already paid, then whatever is the share price, that is your X dividend market price of the share. So what is your answer? What's the growth rate? 2%. So solve this. 0.5 divided by 5.2 plus 0.02. So you'll get 0.116, which is 11.6%. What is 11.6%? This is your cost of equity. I hope you guys have understood how to differentiate whether it is this year's dividend, next year's dividend, whether it is cum dividend share price or X dividend share price, because that's an important math to keep in mind. Alright? So this was about your cost of equity.